gather that information. And when you look specifically at the automotive category, people are going to 18.4 sources of information, primarily online, and many of those being social media related sources as well. So, all very interesting statistics and such, but I think that another statistic that's very important is what some Nielsen research that was produced last week just found in terms of people that were using social media. And in their research, they were delving into the question, what do you use social media research for? So the primary reason that people are using social media and what are they doing with social media is pretty much a no-brainer. It's to build relationships. It's to establish relationships. It's to continue relationships and such. But over the past few years, the number two application for social media has been entertainment. So it's all those people in Farmville playing those Zynga games and things like that. Until last month, when they completed the survey, it was interesting that people doing product research, putting out product recommendations, and doing product shopping through social media has now become the number two use case for social media. So just in relation to how people go about it, the informed purchase decision, and carrying on with our previous presenters here. And as they alluded to, I mean, yesterday, everything was built around the funnel. We would receive some sort of stimulus. We'd go out and develop this big consideration set of alternatives. And we would go through this linear process of winnowing our choices down to where we made a final purchase decision. In today's environment, this has changed. In today's environment, this looks a lot more like something like a neuron, in terms of people are ebbing and flowing in terms of when are they getting that information. They want information anytime, anywhere. They can get that through the devices that they carry in their pockets today. But not only that, they're not just winnowing down their consideration set. Oftentimes, they're expanding their consideration set, or they're changing it. And I know that in one case, when we're doing some of the social media research behind what we're looking at today, we were looking at one lady in Fran who was in one of the forums that we were analyzing. And Fran started off with narrowing her choices down to purchasing a Honda Civic and a Toyota Corolla for her family. Once she put that out there, notified others that we're considering the Honda Civic, the Toyota Corolla, what would you people recommend? You know, what are the pros, what are the cons, and all that kind of thing. Another poster piped up and said, why are you considering those two choices? Why don't you look at the crossover category? And ultimately, Fran completely switched from this economical value category over into a crossover category, where Fran starts down that path of looking at things like the Subaru Forester or the Honda CR-V. So